Hey there, Service Pros. This is Christian from the Workiz product team. In this video, we're going to talk about how to create a custom document from scratch in Workiz. As a field service professional, your company probably already has a handful of documents it uses and provides to customers on a regular basis. We've already covered some of the basic templates that Workiz provides right out of the box in a separate video. Documents like estimates, invoices, and work orders. But let's say you have a different document that doesn't fall into one of those categories. That's where custom documents come in. With Workiz, you can create custom documents from the ground up, customizing them to your exact needs. Let's show you how to do that. Before we get going, we'll want to make sure that we have the custom documents add-on enabled from the marketplace. To do that, we'll click on the marketplace from the navigation bar at the top of the page. That's this icon right here. After that, we'll scroll down to add-ons and select custom documents. All we need to do here is turn this toggle switch on to activate it. Once the feature's been enabled, we'll want to head over to the custom documents settings page. You can do that using this big yellow button right here, but let's show you how to get there the more common way. From the navigation bar at the top of the page, select the cogwheel and then hit Settings. Under General Settings at the top of the page, select Documents. Here, you'll see a list of document templates Workiz provides by default. Invoice, Estimate, and Work Order. Again, if you want to learn more about simply altering these templates, feel free to check out the link in the description below. Let's focus here on creating a custom document from scratch. We'll do that by selecting the Add Custom Document button right here. I'll quickly pull up the existing document I want to recreate in the Workiz Document Editor. That's this one on the left. The first thing we want to do from the Workiz Document Editor is give this document a name. After that, you can select the Email Options button up here to edit the sort of information your customer will see when receiving this document. You can change the email subject line, the email message, and even the specific type of information that your customer should see when viewing the document. Hit Save once you're done. Okay, now onto the document itself. We'll start from the top down. You'll notice this first chunk of the document is split up into two sections, so we'll go ahead and hit the Layout tab and drag and drop the two-section layout onto the document editor. The first section on the left is Logo, so we'll go into the Tools tab and drag the logo onto that empty section. This logo is pulled directly from the one you uploaded into your account settings. If you haven't uploaded your logo and need some help, feel free to check out the link in the description below. I'll quickly resize it so it's a bit smaller. To the right of the logo, we just have three lines of text. I'll go ahead and drag a table onto that empty field. It'll automatically provide us with a 3x3 table, but I don't need that second column, so I'll go ahead and click on the table and select Delete Column. After that, I'll add in the names of the field categories I want to include: job number, date, and PO number. I'll go ahead and add the short code options for those three fields so that the information for this document is automatically generated based on the job details we enter when managing the job itself. We just need to select Insert Values and then choose the short code option we want from the short code library. One thing to point out here is that Workiz doesn't provide a default field for PO numbers, so I went ahead and created a custom field using the Custom Fields add-on. That one's going to be listed under Custom Values. For more information on custom fields, feel free to check out the link in the description below. After that, we'll add another two-section layout directly underneath. Since there's only one line of text on the left, we'll just drag a text box and edit the text. You can enter your phone number manually or use the short code option from the account values. On the right, we need to include the contract type. Again, I went ahead and created a custom field so that it automatically populates the correct information as it's been entered into the job in Workiz. After that, we'll drag a one-section layout and then drag a text box onto that empty space. I'll type the section title and then edit the text to be a bit bigger, bolded, and centered. Underneath that, I'll go ahead and drag another two-section layout. I'll add another table on the left and edit it to fit what I need. I'll remove the second column, but this time I need to add rows. I'll quickly run through this part since it's more of what we just covered: text and short code. On the right, I'll add another table. Just like some of the fields before, these aren't native to Workiz, so I went ahead and created some custom fields for them. I'll add the short code here again. The rest of this document is fairly straightforward. Let's speed past the remaining section so I can show you how custom documents come into play when using Workiz. Once you're done with the document, hit Save at the top of the page. Okay, now let's head over to a job page. Scroll down while on the Details tab and you'll see all of the custom fields I mentioned earlier: PO number, contract type, and all the other ones we included in our document. Okay, now let's scroll back up to the top of the page and select the Files tab. From here, we'll select the Add New button next to Documents and then choose the document we want to create. And there's our custom document, generated intelligently using the information from the job page. That's all we've got for custom documents in this one. Feel free to subscribe to this channel for all the latest on how Workiz can help improve your growing business. And as always, if you have any questions, we're here to help. Thanks for watching.